The Sons of Antiquity present The Hot Take Show. Today's episode,
Gym Etiquette.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to The Hot Take Show. I am your host, Dan, and I'm joined in this lovely studio by my co-host, Evan.
Greetings.
Whether you are a scrawny exomorph or a hulking Chad, the gym is the great equalizer. And today, we are going to give you some tips on gym etiquette. Play the cool intro.
Now, let's clarify. When we're talking about the gym, we're not talking about the treadmill, okay? Just go lift some weights. First off, stop taking so many selfies. Actually, don't even take one selfie. What's the point? And who are you trying to impress? The other guys around you? Or do you think anyone on Instagram cares?
No one's going to care about your gains as much as you will. So why bother, right?
Lots of the time, the people taking selfies are the ones who should not be bragging. The really strong ones often are not posting about it.
Now, let's talk about cleaning equipment. Be courteous. Clean up your butt sweat, but if someone else doesn't, don't get on them. Don't be a little bitch. Just work out.
You're going to shower afterward probably anyway.
Look, nobody's wiping off the bar, let's be honest. And that's where everybody's hands are. That's where you're putting your hands. That's the nastiest part, you know? But a little germs keep your immune system strong, in my opinion. Now, I'm not a medical professional. Don't take this as professional medical advice, please. Don't cancel me.
You do not know what you are talking about.
Next, don't use the squat rack to do things that do not need a barbell rack. I do not want to see you in a squat rack doing some dumbbell curls. I've seen it, usually women, but I've seen lots of men do it too. Please stop using that valuable real estate for what it's not meant to be used for.
Now, as a friendly gym goer, you should always be ready to spot someone else. It's what makes gyms actually a nice place, a community, you might say. However, utilize spotters only occasionally, because nobody wants to be your full-time spotter. They're there to work out, you're there to work out. Don't take advantage of anyone else's time.
Just a set or two. You shouldn't be lifting enough to where you're in danger of being crushed by the barbell for multiple sets for the same exercise. You should do a comfortable level, and there should also be safeguards in place. Most of the time, you don't need a spotter. You can just rest it on a rack if you fail.
Exactly, and really, the bench is the only critical one. I generally don't need a spotter when I'm deadlifting or when I'm squatting. It's only really on bench where I'm worried about crushing my chest. Now, as a personal story, me and Evan once spotted for a guy who was benching over 500 pounds. Me on one side, Evan on the other, and a third guy in the middle. And this dude benched like 525. He was an absolute Zeus. Each pec was as big as my head. Put it that way.
Here's an important question. And a point of debate. Is it impolite to grunt or exclaim? Maybe it's always okay to yell, "Protein!"
It depends on the type of gym you're at. If you are at a really rough and tough powerlifting type gym, absolutely, yeah. If you go to Planet Fitness, of course,
you'll get the lunk alarm. I got it once. It was a proud day for me.
Right on. That's when you realized you didn't need to be there. You were destined for greater things.
Yeah, you need to go to a real gym.
Yeah, hot take. Planet Fitness is not a real gym.
I mean, I always make sure I make it on the free pizza day, but I don't know why. I can't lose weight. Almost like Planet Fitness's whole business model is to keep you fat so you'll keep coming back.
I've been working out at Planet Fitness for a year and I still look like a planet. Yeah, so in general, I think grunting is okay. I'm not upset by it. I'll say that much. But one group of people who I don't want grunting is women. Because anytime women grunt or make any noise at the gym, it just sounds sexual. And that is just too distracting. Which is all the more reason why I am on board with Evan, with his idea about gender segregation in gyms. Tell me about that, Evan.
Yep, I don't deny it. Better yet, you should just allow men. And women can have their own gym. Like YMCA, YWCA. Come on, man.
Sure. Yeah, I think that's a perfectly good setup because I think the type of lifting and the type of workouts that men want and the type of lifting and type of workouts that women want are generally different. And why not just allow them to do those things in a comfortable place where they can not feel distracted and not feel threatened? Because men don't want to be distracted by women in the gym because, hey, women who work out are very attractive. And women don't want to be creeped out by dudes staring at them. So it's a win-win for both. Why not gender segregate gyms? I was at the gym the other day, and this gym is it's pretty serious. You know, I refer to it sometimes as the salty spittoon, like from SpongeBob.
Welcome to the salty spittoon. How tough are you?
So the guy who owns the gym, we'll call him Rufus. Now, Rufus is a mean guy, just like a badass, like a biker. And anyway, I'm over there, I'm doing bicep curls, something like that. And I see him take off his shirt over on the other side of the gym and sit down in a chair, like backwards. And there's this guy behind him with like a needle or some sort of sharp object. Anyway, I keep doing my sets. All of a sudden I hear, and this guy is getting some kind of mole cut off of his back right in the middle of the gym. And everybody there is like a regular, you know, and we're all just looking over there laughing. And this guy was just going to town on his back. I don't know what he was doing, but afterwards he called him Sir Lancelot. So I assume he was just poking into a boil or cutting open a pimple or something like that. But, you know, that's the kind of thing you see in there. And that's the kind of gym that I like. I wouldn't trade it for the world. It's such a cool place. Nobody cares about masks. Everybody's in there to get huge, get swole. And if you got to cut off a mole, you can just do it right there.
Jeez, I think you ripped my mole off.
This all comes back to a personal tragic story for me. Why I used to lift with Daniel, and then COVID happened and everything shut down, and we both lost a lot of gains. However, I bought some equipment for my own home gym, and Daniel eventually went to his own gym by himself. However, I recently had a change in schedule, and well, I have not found the time, I have not made the time to lift. And unfortunately, it shows. I'm weak as can be right now. Let's talk about something I call the call of the barbell. It summons me. Whenever I get near it, I hear it call my name. It just looks over at me longingly and says,
come lift me.
Says, I haven't seen you in a little bit. It would be nice if you'd come by sometime. It hurts my heart whenever I see it. Whenever I see that empty rack with just an empty barbell on it. It makes me sad. One could also call the gym, especially a real gym, the Church of Iron. I fully am behind that. I think it's a special place where, especially if women aren't there, it's almost monastic. And I'm sure it's the same way when women go and there are no men around to bother them. It's a monastic experience where you can just be with your own personal struggle to make yourself better. It's just a holy place. That's all I have to say.
I love it. So let me ask you, dear viewer, what makes the gym so magical? I think what makes it so magical is that it's just a bunch of bros trying to better themselves. Become more masculine by lifting heavy things. It's so simple, yet it means so much to us. We look forward to it, we treasure it, we value it, we make time for it, we dedicate so much time and energy to it. And in the end, if we work hard enough, we see incredible results. And everyone loves that journey. It's almost like a hero's journey, starting off from a small guy or maybe an overweight guy and sculpting yourself into who you want to be. To paraphrase an ancient proverb, man cannot remake himself without suffering, for he is both the marble and the sculptor. There's a lot of camaraderie in gyms, but don't make it gay, and don't be rude. The end.
It's as satisfying to me as coming is, you know, as having sex with a woman and coming. So I'm coming day and night. I mean, it's terrific, right? So, you know, I'm in heaven.